This does not concern you, mortal. You would not, could not, understand. One of our most beloved heroes has fallen. Sir Sagril's passing leaves his legend in peril. A seat in the House of Ballads cannot remain empty, lest the great stories end. And that must never happen. Sir Sagril, Slayer of Vodzigan, Lord of the Morning Mists, and Defender of the Crown of Haxi, was one of our most beloved knights. His tales have endured for generations. Several days ago, he departed to do battle with the Grave Thresh, his most famous and legendary foe. But there was an event, a twist in the story. In this telling, it was the Thresh that bested Sagril. Such an outcome has never happened. I don't know what to make of it. You are bold, but that is not how tales are told in the House of Ballads. Only a worthy Fey hero may finish his quest, complete his story. However, these are strange times. Magic weaves itself in new patterns and change. It is the one thing with which we Fey have no experience. If you so choose, join the other pledges. You too may attempt to defeat the Grave Thresh, recover Sagril's ring, and take his seat in the House of Ballads. The lair of the Thresh is east of this great house, in the hollow of Gorgoroth. In the evenings after dark, you can hear its disturbed slumber. The cries are unsettling. Go now, and make the sound.
This is odd.
This isn't your...
Sir Sagril was a clever rogue of great and merry cheer. Oh, come and listen to the song of he who had no fear, of he who we hold dear.
Brash dustling, you have no role in fey telling. This story belongs to one of us, not some whelp fresh from the cradle. First that strange maiden, now this. What is it you want here in Gorgoroth? Alas, Sagril's is a twisted tale, and we could use every available hand. You may stay, but the seat will never be filled by a mortal. Of that I am certain. We were too late to catch the Thresh as it fed. Now the beast slumbers guarded by the vines and weeds of Gorgoroth. But all is not lost. If we can destroy the roots before they take hold, we can rouse the beast. Come, I'll keep the Thresh occupied while you seek out the heart vines. Keep your eyes open. Don't give up until it's done.
times he drank his weight in wine, and many lovers pleased, and drunk from such idle pleasures, with lethargy was seized, on beds of grass he eased.
I do not like this. Sudden sound and fearsome roar awoke our hero from his rest. The Maid of Windermere had called the grave thresh from its nest to halve at her behest.
That wasn't so terrible.
How can this be? Sir Sagril dead? I do not understand. Such a tragedy has never occurred in this song, not in all the seasons of the telling. At the end of this ballad, Sagril defeats the grave thresh. He is victorious. I don't know how, but someone has changed the song of Sir Sagril. Listen, we are not alone. I do not like this.
Sir Sakril approached the spirit deep within Gorgoroth. He slashed its wicked stalk and root, safe from behind its wrath, slyly from a side path.
Yeah.
the mortal. Amazing. A child of dust has defeated the grave thresh. What a tale you've claimed for yourself, my friend. You are granted the seat of Sir Sagril and all privileges hereto, including membership in the Court of Enchantments. Alas, there is no time for celebration. There has been another incident. The king has asked for you. Excellent. Speak with King Wenson in the oratory. It stands on the crest of Ettenmere, where it once hosted the lords and ladies of the High Court. Take this potion. You will need it to revive Sir Ferrara. Unless mortals have suddenly created a method of resurrection, it's our only option. You will know when the time has come to use it. Now go, find King Wenson. The telling is in your hands now. Off with you.
Thank you.
How may I be of service?
Welcome. it.
You're back. I was so worried that the Fae had taken out the revenge on you. As usual, I was wrong. The Fae has recovered, thanks to your potion. In fact, she wishes to stay in the village for the next several weeks as she recovers. Gorehart will be a new community, a place of compassion, and it's thanks to you. Please, take my sword and buckler. They will serve you well, as they have served me. Bye now.
Need supplies? Try the corner shop. Thank you.
start any trouble.
I was told of ancient days when wise priestess Beala Tirin to goddess Lyria spoke. The people, remembering all after war, called for Durek's fate. Slay them, the foul and wretched tribe, said Dokolfar. Spare them, the poor and miserable beasts, cried Losulfar. Their minds, depraved and hatred-poisoned, twisted. Alfar struck Alfar over drink. At feast, when all else is merry, when peace reigns in havens. Hateful, I am told, were cousins towards each other. From the cold-blessed Firiol, Beala Tirin, with a head to seek Lyria's guidance, set forth on a pilgrimage.
Mitharu, have mercy.
Well done. No one will miss those two. Take this to Shieldring Keep and speak to Tyne Delfric. He'll set you to work on my word alone. Next time I see you,
nice to see you.
Under war sworn banners.
Red Legion.
I'm sorry. Did you say something? I'm a bit lost in thought. Today could be the day, you know? Camden could be the next one to round that corner.
He is my husband. Although we were together for only one night before he marched. His militia fights under the banner of General Finn. We had one night together. And then he departed for 3 long years. He will return. My heart tells me so.
I can't give you much in return, but what I have is yours. The Alfar army is notoriously secretive with their information, and all my pleas for help have been ignored. You might find something in Dyden Hill. That is where Camden volunteered. Of course, that was years ago. Thank you for your kindness. I will be waiting here for news. Farewell.